All right, I need to make a new tee for my PM-1340 GT lathe, the one that comes with a Dorian quick change tool holder. I had temporarily used the one that came with the lathe just because I didn't have my mill, but now that I've got a few minutes, I figured I would hurry up and knock this tee out real quick. I need to take about 15 thousandths off the width before I can start cutting in my steps. So. Just got a piece of paper here. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm running steel with half inch cutting tip. So we're talking 800 RPM, 100 surface feet per minute times 400 divided by half, 800 RPM. So I'm gonna come down, touch off. Paper is about three thousandths thickness. I'm gonna come down, touch off, and then I'm gonna reset my knee. And then I'm going to come in and take 15 thousandths off. Okay, so now I'm just going to come up three more thousandths. Zero out my Z. I'm going to take 10 and then a final cut of 5 just for the heck of it. It'll take 15, no problem. In all honesty, I probably should have fed down on this side. When the tool's cutters, or when the end mill's turning, I like, on cuts like this, I like to turn onto it so you don't leave the raised burr. So on my final cuts, I'll actually just feed right back in the same pattern, the same path. So we'll come up five more thousandths for my finishing cut. Okay, for the final cut now, this last five thousandths, I'm going to turn and the cutter is going to go across, coming onto the edge, so I don't raise that burr. And again, this would have taken it 15 thousandths in one cut, no problem. I just, for demonstration purposes, figured I'd make two cuts. Okay, so you can see what a nice finish that made. The head's in perfect trim. You can see the cross hatches through there, but you can't feel anything. So I'm gonna pull it out and measure it here and see how we're sitting. Okay, this started out at 2 inches. I come in and touched off, raised the knee 3 thousandths to zero it out, and I took 15 thousandths off. I needed to be at 1.985, and that's exactly where I'm sitting, 1.985. Okay, sitting down on my parallels, I've got set in, I've just got my work stop sitting there, so in case I gotta take it in and out. Down on the parallels. Okay, I'm gonna pull the end mill out, and I'm gonna come in with an edge finder now, and I'm gonna have to pick up the back side. Pick up the front side, subtract that from my dimensions, and figure out how much we gotta take off. Okay, so I'm down to 1.985 overall width. I need to be at 1.335. That's 650 thousandths difference. So I need to come in 3 1/4 on each side and down 300. So what I'm going to do is I'm gonna come in, touch off an edge finder, and probably come in shy 10 thousandths in depth and 10 thousandths in width on this, and leave that for a finishing cut. So I'll go ahead and just using a standard edge finder. Okay, start it up here, some feet in. I'm actually going to put a stop, and then I'll use the knee to control from here. So let's put a stop on there. So I'm going to feed table in to where it just smooths it out and just kicks it off to the side. See a kick, so my Y, I'm going to zero my Y out. Okay, there's two ways you can come in and find this edge over here. You can use an edge finder, standard edge finder, and put it in there, come in, touch off, where I'm using a half inch end mill, and this is a 200 thousandths tip edge finder. Traditionally, if you're trying to come over and pick up right off the edge, you're going to come in and then offset at 100 thousandths. But where we're going from an edge finder to a larger end mill, and we're trying to find that edge so we know we have to come in 325 thousandths, you would have to offset it by 150 thousandths back the other direction. That's one way of doing it, or you can use the old paper trick again, come down and just touch off until you just grab the paper. Then compensate by 3 thousandths, and that'll put the end of that edge to that edge of your end mill right on this back side. And then from there, just go ahead and feed the table in 325 thousandths. So there's a couple ways you can do it. I think we're going to use the old paper method on this one and demonstrate that. Okay, so we're going to use the paper trick. We're going to come in, we're going to touch off, we're going to come up, pick up this top edge. Compensate 3 thousandths, zero RDRO. Then we're going to come in and pick up this back edge with the paper. Compensate by 3 thousandths, zero RDRO. So we'll get, and remember, we're using a half inch end mill, 100 surface feet per minute. It's going to end up being 800 RPM. Okay, just grabbed it. So we're going to come up. And zero out Z. Then we're going to raise it up a little. And then feed the table in till it just picks the paper up right there. Zero RY. Okay. So we're going to feed in. We need to go in a total of 300 thousandths, so we're going to go in. Oh, we'll go in just, we'll go in 20 thousandths shy, so we'll go into 280 thousandths. And then we're going to come up. There's our zero, and we're going to go up. Let's take Let's take 40,000. Let's take 30,000 there to start with. Change of plan here. We're actually going to plunge this so we make it a little easier on our tool life here. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to advance this, put a little bit of lube on there. Just going to advance it a little bit and plunge down. So it feels like to plunge. They do seem to do a little better on a plunge. So let's just take the light. Yeah, I'm 20 thousandths shy on the depth. I think I'm about 25 thousandths on the width of the T. So we'll just feed here probably. Add 50 thousandths. 50, 60 pounds here at a time. Did a little test fit there, and I'm just going to take and kiss this bottom edge another 5 thousandths of all. We went in the T slot on the compound, but it was just a little more snug than I like it. So I've taken another 5 thousandths off the bottom edge. Okay, that'll pretty much about have it there. Now I'm going to come into the sim. I don't need to reset my depth because I already know what my depth is based off of this. And I take it out and put it right back into my stop. So what I'll do now is I'll come over and I'll pull paper on this edge and move in my 325 thousandths on this other edge. Okay, so now we're going to use the paper trick again. Put it on. And I'm just going to pull. Now this time we're going to be cutting on this edge. So we're going to be coming out on the Y travel. Just pull the paper right there. Okay? So then I will come back out with my Y 3 thousandths. Right there. Zero my Y, and I'm going to come out with the table. I need to go 325 for my total, so I'm going to come out and go 315. That'll give me 10 thousandths, make that maybe a passing spring effect. So we're going to do the same thing here. We're going to plunge it. Put a little bit of, I'm just using that super cut. Sulfur-based dark oil is all. So now I'm going to come out and I'm just going to plunge it. Get over here so we can actually, I think I'm going to go to the other side, so I'm not plugging on these plunge caps on that. perfect coming off of it. I got my speed set with just a straw color. A couple of these on the tails, you can see where they're just starting to go to a goldish blue. So our RPM and feed rate and everything is pretty much optimum right there for the steel blank as well as the high speed steel end mill. Again, I'm moving about 40-50 thousandths at a time on my X-Travel here. I'm just shy of a quarter turn before I plunge. And I'm going to go 325 and I'm going to make that a clean cut and pretty much call this done. Okay, so here it is after deburring. Break it loose, pull it out, run a file over the edge, deburred everything. Let's do a test fit. Little snug going in. Oh, there we go. Perfect. Goes in. Have to measure it, but it's probably just a few thousandths below. You don't want that any higher than the base, the side of your compound, but there it is. Now I can put my stud on it, put my Dorian quick change tool post back on, and we are in business.